Welcome to the tech race. Treadmills that are able to simulate a real environment, to check health and even reverse the effects of gravity. Treadmills meet high tech. Training at only 20% of your body weight is now possible. This anti-gravity treadmill heavily reduces recovery time and pain after experiencing an injury.
Oh, and it's great. I love it. It's like running on the moon.
In Bisham Abbey, at the High Performance Centre of the English Institute of Sport, we've been able to understand how this technology works.
It's a regular treadmill, but it kind of sits in a balloon that essentially lifts the athlete up slightly, so it reduces their body weight, so they can run along in a normal running fashion without the full weight of their body whilst they run.
The differential air pressure, DAP technology, is the crux of the matter. This system creates a positive pressure in the air chamber whilst being inflated. The difference in air pressure, in turn, produces a lifting force around the lower and upper body to counteract gravity, efficiently unweighting the user.
That's technology that has allowed the rehabilitation of athletes in a way that we wouldn't be able to do otherwise.
So it's important to be in training for competition constantly. And a few weeks back in training, I picked up a stress fracture in my metatarsal. And I thought I was going to be out for a long time. But then I came across this machine, and I'm absolutely amazed at how quickly I'm recovering. So I do think I'm going to be back in competition within a couple of weeks.
Users must wear neoprene shorts that zipper into the air chamber, forming an airtight seal in which the system employs the differential air pressure technology.
So if you picture a marathon runner who spends a lot of time plodding the streets, you know, a lot of miles, 100 miles a week, probably more, that's a lot of stress on bones and joints and muscles. So the treadmill allows them to perform exercise in a running specific way. But because it allows you to take off a portion of your body weight, you can run, but with minimum stress on the bones, so they don't get the impact on the ground that you would when you're running on the roads.
The treadmill's display panel has three variable controls. The first allows the person to decide the percentage of weight they want to bear in a given moment.
I'm gonna go all the way down to 20% of my body weight, which means I weigh 20 kilos. And my feet are barely touching the ground.
The second variable control is speed, enabling the user to reach up to 12 miles per hour. Incline is the third variable control. Reaching a maximum 15%, users can gradually adjust inclination to reach optimal performance conditions. Combining these three variables with precision and accuracy tailors an ideal healing and training environment for athletes.
Kind of like astronauts experience when they're bouncing around on the moon.
Bones are less resistant to stress than glass or metal. The force exerted on bones can deform them, causing strain, in the worst case, causing a fracture. The incidence of stress fractures in the tibia and other long bones is high in distance runners. In sprinters, feet tend to be more affected.
I'm used to training at quite high volumes and intensities, and because of the injury that I've picked up, I obviously can't maintain those levels. So what the treadmill allows me to do is to keep training at quite high volumes and intensities, but still helping me recover. So it's completely aware of my limitations and my needs, and it means that I can still maintain my physical form.
Any elite athlete's biggest nightmare is getting injured. Spending months in rehabilitation interrupts performance development and gets in the way of important competitions. This anti-gravity treadmill creates optimal conditions for effective and fast recovery.
So if someone's injured and they're in the middle of their rehabilitation, it's a good way of introducing them back into training because they're able to train, but with minimal stress on the body.
Technology is what offers a competitive advantage. Leading up to competition, athletes and coaches keep these developments to themselves, to then release into the world once the games are over, hopefully with a few medals under their belt.